I remember the first time I tried importing a CSV file into MySQL Workbench. I was lost, frustrated, and stuck with errors everywhere. But once I learned the right steps, it became so simple. Today, I'm going to show you exactly how I do it, using a file I created called students_data. Let me walk you through how I import this data into MySQL Workbench without any hassle. Let's get started. Let me show you how the data is stored in my CSV file. It contains three columns, student ID, student name, and email, with 10 rows of data inserted. It's a simple data set. Step 1. Open MySQL Workbench. To import data from a CSV file, open MySQL Workbench. Step 2. Connect to the database. Connect to the database where you want to upload the data. In my case, I will use test_db. Step 3. Open the table data import wizard. There are two ways to do this. First, right-click on the database name and select Table Data Import Wizard. Second, expand the hierarchy tree by clicking on the database name. Then right-click on the Tables menu and select Table Data Import Wizard. Both methods open the same wizard. Step 4. Select the CSV file. Choose the CSV file you want to import. In my case, it's a student_data.csv stored in my E drive. Once selected, click Next to proceed. Step 5. Select the destination. Here you have two options. First, overwrite an existing table. Second, create a new table for the imported data. I will choose the second option and create a new table. Since my database is test_db, I will name the table Students. Then click Next. Step 6. Configure import settings. Keep the encoding set to UTF-8. MySQL Workbench automatically detects that the file format is CSV. If you need to adjust CSV settings, click the wrench icon to fine-tune them. In most cases, the default settings work fine. You can also modify the data type of the columns before importing. Once everything looks good, click Next. Step 7. Final step. Import the data. You will see a summary of the operation that will be executed. Click Next to start the import process. If needed, you can view the logs before finishing the operation. Click Finish and the data will be imported. To verify the import, run a select statement. If the data appears correctly, the process is complete. That was simple, right? However, things get tricky when the dataset contains date values. For example, if we add a new column, date of birth, the dates might be stored in different formats. MySQL cannot import inconsistent date formats. So we need to standardize the format to YYYY-MM-DD before importing. Formatting dates in CSV. Select the date of birth column. Press Ctrl+1 in Windows or Command+1 in Mac to open the format cell windows. Go to the number tab, select custom, and enter YYYY-MM-DD in the format field. Click OK, save the file, and return to MySQL Workbench. Importing the formatted data. Now repeat the same import process, but this time make sure to set the date of birth column's data type to date time instead of text. At the bottom, you will see the date format field. In this text box, you need to specify the exact date format used in your CSV file. Since we stored the dates in YYYY-MM-DD format, enter %Y-%M-%D. Nothing else, not even a space. Ensure that this field matches the date format in your CSV file exactly without any extra character or spaces. Once done, click Next and proceed with the import. That's it. And that's how we import a CSV using MySQL Workbench. Thanks for watching, and I hope you found this tutorial helpful. If you have got any experiences or tips for importing CSV files, please leave them in the comment below. And if you are looking for more database tutorials, Be sure to check out my other videos. Thanks for watching. I am Manish from RebellionRider.com.